हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दी वर्चुअल क्लासरूम ऑफ सोशल स्टडीज। इन आर टुडेज वीडियो वी विल लर्न द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, दैट इज एनवायरनमेंट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी व्हाट इज एन एनवायरनमेंट। द आंसर इज वेरी सिंपल, व्हाट एवर यू सी इन योर सराउंडिंग्स इज कॉल्ड एनवायरनमेंट। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एयर, वाटर, स्कूल बिल्डिंग, पार्क, फॉरेस्ट, हाउस एक्सेट्रा, दीज आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट। राइट नाउ यू आर सिटिंग इन योर होम, योर होम इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट। वेन यू स्टडी इन द स्कूल इज ऑल्सो एन एनवायरनमेंट। वेन यू प्ले इन द पार्क और प्ले ग्राउंड, द पार्क और प्ले ग्राउंड इज ऑल्सो एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट। सो बेसिकली all the elements which are presented in our surroundings is called environment. Now the word environment is originated from French word, and the French word is environner. The word environner means neighborhood or surroundings. So basically the word environment means our neighborhood or surroundings. Place, people, things and nature that surround any living organism is called environment. In environment, all the elements are included, whether it is a place, whether they are people, whether things are present or nature. All the elements are included in environment. It is a combination of natural and human made phenomena. It means both natural and human elements are included in environment. It includes both biotic and abiotic components. Now the word biotic means world of living organism. For example, plants, animals, these are example of biotic. It means in environment living organism are include. And abiotic means world of non-living elements. For example, land, rainfall, climate, temperature, etc. These are example of abiotic components. So basically in environment both biotic and abiotic means both living and non-living elements are included. Now what are the benefits of our environment? It is very simple. Environment is our basic life support system. It means our life is totally dependent on our environment. It gives us various things. For example, the air we breathe, the water we drink, the food we eat, the land on which we live. So the water, the air, the food, the land, all these things are provided to us by our environment. Our survival or our living is totally dependent on our environment. Now what are the components of environment? As you can see in this diagram, there are three components of environment. The first is natural component, second human components, and third human made components. In natural components, air, water, land, living things, all these things are included. In human components, individual, from individual to family, from family to community, from community to religion, then religion to educational institutions, economic institutions, political situations, all these things are human components. It means the people come under the human components of environment. And the things which we made are called human made components. For example, the buildings we make, the parks we construct, the bridges that are constructed, the roads that are constructed for transportation, the industries, the monuments, all these things are constructed by human beings. So these are human made components. So basically environment includes very minute components all human made components or elements are included in the environment. Now, what is a natural environment? I hope you all know this. The answer is very simple. Land, water, air, plants and animals comprise the natural environment. It means all those things which are presented in the nature are called natural environment. Broadly, natural environment can be classified into four major domains. The word domain means area. So basically, natural environment has four major areas or territories or subcategories. First one is lithosphere. Lithosphere means land. Hydrosphere. Hydrosphere means water. Atmosphere, a thin layer of air. And biosphere comprises all these three domains. In this diagram, you can see lithosphere is land. Hydrosphere is water. Atmosphere, the thin layer of air which is presented above us, and biosphere includes all these things. Now, you must be wondering how to remember all these domains. The answer is very simple. I have made a easy trick for you to learn these four major domains. For example, Lakshya has amazing books. In Lakshya, L stands for lithosphere. In H stands for hydrosphere. In amazing, A stands for atmosphere. And in books, B stands for biosphere. So, Lakshya has amazing books, lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere, and biosphere. You can make these kinds of mnemonics or memory tricks by yourself. First of all, what is lithosphere? Any type of land is called lithosphere. It is the solid crust or the hard top layer of the earth. It means the crust of the earth or the first surface level or hard top layer of the earth is called lithosphere. It is made up of rocks and minerals and covered by a thin layer of soil. It means in lithosphere, rocks are found, minerals are found, and a thin layer of soil is also present. It means on land we can find rocks, minerals, and soil. It is an irregular surface with various landforms such as mountains, plateaus, plains, valleys, etc. It means there are different landforms which are included in lithosphere, and mountains, plateaus, plains, valleys, deserts, etc. All these have different kind of structure or surface areas. Landforms are found over the continents. As we all know that land is also found on the continents and also on the ocean floors. So basically, any type of land or landform is called lithosphere. Now, there are advantages of lithosphere, and these are: it provides us forest. Forests are very useful for us. Forest provides us various things. For example, medicines, trees, paper, other types of food products, flowers, etc. are produced from the forest, grasslands for grazing for the animals, land for agriculture and human settlements. We all know that all the human activities and agriculture activities are performed on the land. Human construct various types of settlements, various types of structures, which are constructed on the land. It is also a source of mineral wealth. Various types of minerals are found in lithosphere, for example, iron, copper, mica, gypsum, etc. These types of minerals are also found on lithosphere. And minerals are very important from the economic point of view. Now, what is hydrosphere? The domain of water is referred to as hydrosphere. It means it includes rivers, lakes, seas, oceans, etc. any kind of source of water, whether it is a river or a lake or a sea or ocean or a spring or pond, all these are hydrosphere. Hydrosphere is essential for all our living, for all living organism. We cannot live without hydrosphere. Hydrosphere is very must for all of us. Now, the third domain of natural environment is atmosphere. Atmosphere is thin layer of air that surrounds the earth. I am repeating again, atmosphere is nothing but a thin layer which is surrounded in our earth. The gravitational force of earth holds the atmosphere around it. It means it is the gravity of earth that ensures that atmosphere doesn't go up. It holds the atmosphere in its grasp. Atmosphere is very important for all of us as it protects us from the harmful rays and scorching heat of the sun. As you all know that ozone layer protects us from the UV rays or ultraviolet rays of the sun, and ozone layer is presented in our atmosphere. So atmosphere is a thin layer that surrounds the earth and it protects us from the harmful and scorching heat of the sun. Atmosphere comprises number of gases, dust and water vapors. As you can see in this diagram, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, argon and all other kinds of gases are found in the atmosphere. Change in atmosphere produces changes in the weather and climate. It means any kind of change will lead to changes in the weather and climate. For example, air pollution. Air pollution has caused many changes in our weather and climate, as the amount of rainfall is also affected by the air pollution. Acid rain is the consequence of the air pollution. So, any kind of change in the atmosphere will affect the weather and climate. So, in today's session, we have studied what is environment. The word environment means our surrounding or neighborhood. Then we have learned the components of environment, natural components, human components and human-made components. Then we have studied what is natural environment. All those things which are present in the nature is called natural environment. And we have studied the three domains of the natural environment. First one is lithosphere. Lithosphere means land. Hydrosphere. Hydrosphere means any kind of source of water. Or third one is atmosphere. Atmosphere is a thin layer of air. So in next video, we will discuss about biosphere and what is human environment and many other things. Thank you.